Hi friends, this is Agnello Rajesh here from St. Angelo's Professional Education, and we are on Inspiring Conversations. Today's topic is branding. Think about what people are doing on Facebook today. They are keeping up with their friends and family, but they are also building an image, an identity for themselves, which in a sense is their brand. They are connecting with the audience that they want to connect to. It's almost a disadvantage if you are not on it now. Friends, branding is a very, very important word for every entrepreneur. Today is a world of brands. Brands are everywhere. Amul, Reliance, Tata, Mahindra, Colgate, Mercedes, Rolex, BMW, Sony, Assam Tea, HMT Watches, LIC, all are very powerful and daily seen brands around us. As an entrepreneur, you need to understand and work upon your market status, image of your enterprise, promise that you make to your customers, expectations that you are building in the minds of your potential customers, perception that's being created about your enterprise in the minds of the people, trust that has been built in the process of doing business, credibility that has been developed from transactions, goodwill and reliability that your brand enjoys in the marketplace. All these factors will lead to recognition with the right emotions and build the required reputation for your enterprise. Friends, all these are the points where an entrepreneur should focus on and keep on improving the results. The more he focuses, the stronger is the brand that he is creating. Personal brand is nothing but your quality of interaction that you have with your customers, employees, vendors, government, and absolutely anybody and everybody around you. Branding is a lot of like and unlike. On Facebook, it's like and unlike, and it takes a lot to make a brand. One should always focus on building brands brick by brick, day by day, and through sheer focus and depth. This is what brand is all about. A brand is not just a logo, advertising, marketing, or corporate identity only. A brand is confidence, passion, belonging, action, security, a set of unique values, a responsibility, a performance, an expectation. For example, Tata means reliability. Domino's means delivery on time. Amul means the best butter available. These are great brands, and it is not limited only to marketing, but branding is an identification. The growth for a successful brand can be phenomenal. The valuation of the globally popular drink Coca-Cola is more than the GDP of Bolivia, Kenya and Bahrain put together. And can you believe it that Coke sold only 9 bottles when it began business in 1886. Everything around us can be branded. Products like Titan watches, services like Airtel, people like Sachin Tendulkar, places like Goa and even religions can be branded. A rightly created brand can take your enterprise to amazing heights. Every name mentioned above has seen those heights of growth and are still growing. When people use your brand as a verb, you can consider it to be your success. The common brands we use in our daily life as verbs and actions are like Xerox those notes, Skype me, Google it. These are all very strong examples. The right brand will always guarantee quality, evoke a very positive desire, and help the customers to connect. A cafe coffee day is not selling coffee. It's an atmosphere. It's an experience. It's a feel-good factor associated with coffee. I'm sure you get all these points right. Like intention, authenticity, and energy cannot be faked. You cannot fake a brand. If you're telling a story you don't believe in, your audience will sense it instantly. They'll feel it and act on that feeling, even if they can't justify their feelings in words. The good news is that they will pick up just as instantly on your genuine enthusiasm and conviction. You don't need to stand on your head or shout or sing to show that your passion is real. You just need to let yourself feel it, instead of suppressing it. Authentic energy is contagious. If your story truly excites you and you let that excitement show, it will resonate with your audience. How do you convey energy or enthusiasm for a product if the product's not so great, or if you're number 3 or 4 in the market. Unfortunately for many business people, the trick is to find something about the product or service that does excite you. Even if it's something as small as the color of the item or the look of the service website, then focus on the aspect of your story that makes you feel genuinely enthusiastic. All this will definitely help. Today, brands are not only restricted to products and services, but today they also communicate and behave in a different way. Today's brands are like Google Info, YouTube Films, eBay Stuff, Facebook Friends. All these brands shout, "Use me." They pull you towards them. They integrate your daily lifestyle with them. That's what today's brands do. For creating a brand in the minds of the people or consumers or customers, it took radio 38 years to reach 50 lakh people. TV took 13 years, internet took 4 years, and Facebook took just 2 years. These are today platforms which are also used for strengthening brands. These are branding effects of something which we never came across before. The atmosphere of enterprise is changing at rapid speed. What was never thought before has become a norm today. Did you know that 25% of India's population with the highest IQ is greater than the total population of the United States of America? Indian entrepreneurs created world's most successful companies in the last 15 years. They created brands which today not only demand respect but also command it. Companies like Infosys and Wipro have created global histories. These companies did not even exist a few years back. Indian entrepreneurs feature amongst the top 10 richest people in the world, something that the world never expected. All these means that brands are all how you make them as an entrepreneur. You make them, you unmake them. They mean what you want them to mean. They mean you. As an entrepreneur, the endeavor has to be on how you can make a successful brand in these challenging times. Because when the going is tough, the tough get going. I wish you all the best, and I'm sure you're also in the process of creating a globally renowned brand. This is Agnello Rajesh from St. Angelo's Professional Education for an episode of Inspiring Conversations. Thank you. We'll be right back.